The third bomb threat in 3 days in Daytona Beach. This one phoned into a bank and forced police to evacuate an entire office building. A threatening call came into the Fifth Third Bank on Seabreeze Boulevard this morning. The caller demanded money be wired to London, and another man got on the phone and he wanted the money be brought outside. The caller said they would detonate a bomb if the bank didn't cooperate. The same thing happened at a Publix in Daytona Beach and at a Winn-Dixie store in Daytona Beach Shores over the weekend.
The recent bomb threats understandably have Daytona Beach quite cautious, and that's why they sent in a hazardous material team when a judge got a suspicious letter this morning. They tested that letter for both anthrax and ricin. WESH 2's Claire Metz live at the Justice Center. So Claire, they said they just weren't going to take any chances here.
Not in today's world, Sion. Needless to say, they will act with caution under these circumstances. A judicial assistant thought there was something unusual about this letter, that it looked funny, it might even have had some bulk. She turned it over to sheriff's deputies, who called in the hazmat team to check for foreign or harmful substances. The Justice Center did not have to be evacuated, but the suspicious letter was sealed in plastic by deputies and left near the dumpsters for hazmat to investigate. The letter, addressed to Judge Michael Hutchison, appeared hastily taped together with no information about the sender, and deputies felt something slightly weighty inside.
What they were feeling was the binding of the letter folding. And that was the reason why we went ahead on and tested everything.
The two deputies who handled the letter were isolated as a precaution, while the hazmat team suited up and probed that suspicious envelope. They then opened it, checking for anything explosive or otherwise substantial.
It was a letter, really no powdery substance inside the letter. It was a letter to a specific judge.
But even without the obvious, paper can be laced with unseen dangerous materials. So hazmat swabbed it on site, checking for possible toxic substances.
We did the two big ones. We did anthrax and ricin, and it came back negative for the anthrax and the ricin.
It was, in fact, only a letter about an ongoing case on the judge's docket. It did not threaten the judge, and it did not contain anything harmful.
We were able to let the individuals go back, the two sheriff's officers that came into contact with it, and we didn't find any threat.
Good deal there. One other thing that perhaps led people to have questions was that the judge's name was misspelled, yet he's been handling this sender's case for a while, so that kind of set them off as well. Now, needless to say, this did not force a courthouse evacuation. Matter of fact, it was business as usual everywhere, but over near the dumpsters outside the Justice Center, while the hazmat did its work. Reporting live in Daytona Beach, Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.